Hi, we saw in the previous lecture a few prerequisites to understand the algorithm that I'm going to discuss right now. The first prerequisite was that if you have n to the 3 by 4 number of elements, you can sort these many elements in order n time. I'm sure you would have figured out how. If not, pause the video right now and then figure it out, because you cannot go further without understanding this. Okay, so if you can't figure out how, I can give you a hint here. So basically, you have n to the 3 by 4 number of elements. You take, if you use merge sort, say, you take so much time. Alright, and this, as you can see, can also be written as n to the 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 log n, order of so much. You know that constants do not matter when you're considering asymptotic time complexity. So this would become n to the 3 by 4 times log n, order of this. As you know, log n, definitely, let me write it here, n to the 1 by 4 is always greater than log n. Log n means what? Number of digits in n. But 4th root of n is much better than log n, which means this entity here is much better than 4th root of n, which means this is less than order of n to the power of 3 by 4 times n to the power of 1 by 4, which is order of n. Okay, next. Now let's look at what exactly is the randomized algorithm to find median. How to find median of a given sample S. Okay. Let me give a fictitious account of what would happen in case I came to your rescue. Assume this is me. It doesn't look like me, but assume it's me. Okay, this is Sudarshan, and this is you. And this is you. Formless, maybe. I don't know how you look like, so just put a rectangle here. This is you. So now you must find the median of a given sample S. S has 1 million elements. One way you can handle this is sort S and find the middle point. Fine, you're done. Can you better this? Now, you have limited capacity, let's assume. You can only do, your strength is order n computations. Any order n computations you can do, but you cannot do anything more than that. Now, you come and seek my help, okay? And my job is to simplify things for you so that you can use your order n power to compute the median of the given sample S. Now, the question is, I'm going to help you the following way. The moment you give me yes, I'm going to give you a D and a U such that the median M, see, median exists. I don't know what that median is. All I can give you is a D and a U such that median lies between D and U. It need not necessarily lie in the middle. It lies between D and U in S. I repeat. You look at S, sort S. In case you sort S, you're not sorting S. In case you sort S, you will get a D on the left of M, some U on the right of M. I'm going to give you one such thing, one such pair, D, U. With the help of this, the question is, can you compute the median of S? I will also ensure, when I give you such a D and U, I'll also ensure the following. What do I ensure? Let me write this down. This is S. And you have the median here, let's say. I'll give you a D and a U. This is M. This is M, which is not known, by the way. Which is not known. I don't know what M is, but I can guarantee you that M is between D and U. I'm giving such D and U. I'm also guaranteeing you one thing. The number of elements in this slab, let me highlight it. In this slab is less than n to the 3 by 4. Now, this is what Sudarshan can give you. With this much of data, can you do something and find what is the median? Is the question. The answer is, yes, you can do it. How? What you do, this is you, this is you, this is you. What you do is the following. I have given you a d and a u such that d is less than m less than u. D is given to you, u is given to you. You can start from all, you can look at all elements of S once, look at all of S once and compute how many elements are there in this slab, in this slab. How many elements are, it's very easy. You take all elements of S and see how many of them are less than D. You will get this. Let me call this LD. Please note, LD is not an array. LD is the number of elements less than D. I repeat, number of elements less than D is LD. Let me highlight that. LD is the number of elements less than D. You can also compute this, the number of elements less than, I'm sorry, greater than U. Let me call it LU. The moment I give you, so this is all I give you. I give you a D and a U. I give you a D and a U. And you can of course compute LD and LU. Once you compute LD, and once you know that M lies between D and U, you can also do the following. You can compute all the elements between D and U and put that into an array C. Now I repeat from the beginning quickly. You are given S with 1 million elements. What I do, you must find the median. What I do is I'll give you a D and a U such that D and U encloses M. With this, you can do the following. You can compute LD, you can compute LU, you can also compute this array C. Rather, you can get this array C. Alright, it need not necessarily be sorted, but you can get all the elements between D and U. Let me call that C. I repeat, all the elements between D and U is called C. Now what? Now you're gonna sort C. Now wait. The whole exercise of the whole point here is to avoid sorting, right? Sorting S, by sorting S you can easily find median. You don't need Sudarshan's help. But the point is, Sudarshan is making your life simple. He is giving you a D and a U such that the number of elements between D and U is n to the 3 by 4. Which means the number of elements in C is going to be n to the power of 3 by 4. What you do is you sort C. It is going to take order n time, which you can afford. As I said, you can only do order n computations on that corona. Alright, so you can only do so much. And now you can find, how do you find LD? By running through this entire array, which again is done in order n time. How do you find LU? Again in order n time. How do you find C? Again order n time. You look through the entire thing and put all the elements between D and U into this basket C. This again can be done in order n time, finding C. And sorting C again can be done in order and time, which means all these computations can be done in order and time, which means so far so good. What all have you done? You have taken D and U from my side. I have given you D and U. You have computed a LD and a LU and a C, and you have sorted C. C is now sorted. Now what? You have the following now. The set S has a median which I am supposed to find. Okay, let me change color. I have given you a D and a U, and you now have C, which is all the elements between D and U in a sorted way. And now LD is also given to you, which means you know what this number is, LD. Can you now find M? It is very easy to find M. How do you find M? You take N by 2 and subtract it from LD and find what element is this in C. This will be your median. How is this true? Pause the video for a while, for a minute, and think how the array C, of course, houses M. This is C. The array C, of course, houses M, this particular thing from here to here between D and U is C. It houses M. What is M? If you know LD, you will know M. M definitely is n by 2th element of S. S comprises of n elements. Whatever is n by 2, find that, subtract that from LD, you will get this much of this value. This value of C will give you the median. And there you have found the median. Now let's get back. What have you done so far? You have done only order n computations all throughout, but you are getting an answer which is right, as you can see. Now the question is, you have used Sudarshan so far. What if Sudarshan is missing in action? Sudarshan is not there at all. Then what? There is no one for you to get D and U from. Sudarshan gave you D and U. He also ensured that the number of elements between D and U is n to the power of 3 by 4. But what if Sudarshan is missing in action? What will you do then? Now, still you can compute the median in order n time. You must fetch yourself D and U. How to find? Sudarshan is missing right now. The question is, how to find D and U? Let's take a minute's thought and let's see. Is there a way to find D and U? There doesn't seem to be one. But I'll give you a technique through which D and U can be found, such that the number of elements between D and U, such that first point, D and U encloses M. Second point, the number of elements between D and U, elements between D and U is n to the 3 by 4 or less. How can you guarantee this? How can you get this? I'll give you a way to do this. Sudarshan is going to give you a way to do this, but he's not going to tell you how exactly this works. I'm going to do the following. I'll take the set R, initially empty, and randomly pick n to the 3 by 4 elements from S. Note, I'm picking n to the 3 by 4 elements. You have seen this n to the 3 by 4 somewhere else also, but don't connect that with this. I'm picking n to the 3 by 4 elements from S. R might have repetitions, I don't care. What I do is, I pick n to the 3 by 4 elements, which means the number of elements in R is n to the 3 by 4. Let me draw R right now. Let me draw R. This is R. I sort the elements of R. R has n to the 3 by 4 elements. I can sort it in order and time. I'll sort it. Once I sort, I can find the midpoint of R. MR is the midpoint of R. Please note, it has nothing to do with the median of S. Your motive is to find the median of S. I find the midpoint of R. Note, R is sorted. I've done it in order and time. And I look at an element here, that is square root of n distance away from MR. Whatever this point is, I go root n amount of time on the left side. I'll call this my D. I'll go root n amount of units on the right side. I'll call it U. Choose this as D, choose this as U. Automatically, this will be satisfied, this will be satisfied, is what Sudarshan is guaranteeing you, but he is not telling you how. That will be done in the next lecture when I discuss complexity. Now the point is, you now have an algorithm which gives you the median. How? Put everything together. Probably may have to see this lecture once again to see how I started off and where I ended. With the help of Sudarshan, you could find median in order and time. Now, without the help of Sudarshan, you are able to find median in log n time. See how I'll start with the next lecture. I'll try to explain the first 2 minutes of my next lecture, the algorithm, and then we discuss about the complexity.